morning everyone. Welcome back to your class 1 science class. And you know the previous chapter of already completed. So today we will start the new chapter. This is your 7th chapter. Open the page number 29. This is our plant world. So today we will start the new chapter about plant world. So first of all, you have to know what is this plant world. You know where those all plants we can see about those plants. There are various types of plants and we can see them at forest also. So plant world means that we have to learn about every plant, right, which we can see outside of the house, those all big trees, small trees which we can see in our roof of the house, and those which we plant it in the tub. So those all plants, of course, their types and their examples, so those everything we have to learn. So that is called the plant world. So first of all, see the book. When you look around, we find the different types of plants. You know, right? When we look outside of the house, we can see there are different kinds of plants. Some are very big, some are very small, some are in the medium size. Some are have the fruits and some have only flowers. So there are various kinds, various types of the plants. So that's why we call them the plant world. And here you can see some plants are big and some are small, as I told you just. So first we have to know about the big plant. So big plant are which plants are very big in size. Those are the big plants, but at first they are not all are big. First of all, they have some seeds, and so seeds grow into plant. Then those plant make the big trees. As you all are one, you all are small baby, and now you all are in class 1. And after some days, some years, you will all grow up. So like that, plants, as you know, plants are all the living things. They have life also. So one day they all grow up. And those trees we call the big trees when they grow big. And they have the big strong stem. So those are the called the tree. Those are called the tree. So big plant example is tree. Okay, that is one. And those trees have many examples. You know about the mango trees. You love to eat mango fruit, right? Those mango tree, lychee tree, banyan tree, neem tree. Those all have the strong stem, strong big stem. So that's why those are all are the tree. Okay, and you have to remember this. That's the tree look like this, and banyan tree have some small stem which is just floating from the upper side, and you can see here it have the strong and big stem, right? This stem is very big and very thick also. So the tree look like this, and their examples are banyan tree, mango tree, neem tree. Okay, so that is about the tree, and that is big plant. Okay, and there are also you can see small plants, and those small plants has various examples, various types. But today we learnt about only the herbs and shrubs. So first of all, see the small plants are which are not growing very much or very big. They are, when they all grow up, they are have the medium size or small size. So first of all, you can see the shrubs. I will give you the examples. You can understand it, that is rose and tulsi. Tulsi, which plants we have everyone's house, and we can see this. You can see the tulsi plant is not very big, it's just small height. So that's why tulsi and rose tree, about rose, those are the flower plants, and those are the examples of shrubs. Okay, and they are not so big and strong stem, they have the thin stem, thin and strong. And the herbs which is the smaller than shrubs, it's the shrub side is like that the herb is the smaller than shrubs. Okay, herbs is smaller than shrubs. And example of herbs are sunflower and wheat. There is also some examples, aloe vera, also methi, also those are the example of the herbs, but they have the very weak stem. They have the weak stem. And those are the wheat, which is the food grain, and sunflower also. So there is about big plant and small plant. And there are various types of small plants, but today just we learned about shrubs and herbs, and other rest of those small plants we will learn to the next class. Okay everyone, so read this first page of this chapter and about big plants and small plants. First of all, you have to know what are the big plants and why they are big plants, and their examples also. As I told you, the trees and their examples, berry and mango and neem, and they are looking like this, and they have the strong stem. So those are big plants, and the small plants, they haven't any strong stem. They have thin stem, little bit hard stem, but their height is not so big. Their height is small and smaller also. Okay, so learn this, and you have to remember these things. Okay everyone, so that's all.